Hello, in this video, I'll show you how to get your icons and buttons to spin, flash, change color, and change icon by using RomRider's custom button card, which I installed via HACS. I'll also show you some advanced techniques not directly shown in the documentation. First thing, let's add a ordinary button card. I've made an input boolean, which I've called button, and I've given it an icon, obviously of a fan there. Keep everything default and hit save. As you can see, it's an ordinary button that goes on and off, but that's boring. So let's jazz it up a little bit. So we go to edit, we go to the code editor because we want to change that title there. So from button, I'm going to call it custom button. And don't worry about that. There is no visual editor for the custom button, but as you can see, the button is still functioning. So that's all well and good, but it didn't make any difference, Dave. Well, let's make it spin. So on the next line, I'm going to add a state. And I'm going to test the state to see if the value of that state is on. If it's on, first of all, let's change the color. So let's have a red. So as you can see, when it's on, it's red, and off is the default color. So I've got red there. This will take pretty much any color name. So we can have green, blue, pink, one of my favorites, orange. So this will also take RGB values. So you can type in something like RGB, open brackets, and then let's go for, I don't know, 128, 255, 255, or 50. Drop this down a bit. Let's have 50. And there are plenty of CSS color charts on the web. So things like this, you can pick your own color, any color you like. Just copy the value there and put it in there. Okay, that's nice, but it's not the point of the video. We want to make it spin. So next line, I'm going to call that spin, and I want it to be true. So what we're doing here is the state of this entity. If the state is on, make it red and spin it. It's as simple as that. That's all well and good, but you know, there's no control. It's either on or off. It's spinning, yeah, but I want to make it faster. I'm going to take out this spin command. Instead, I am going to now edit a styles, and then within styles, I'm going to edit the icon, and then in icon, I'm going to do an animation, and then within animation, I'm going to do a rotating. I want it to rotate for, let's go 2 seconds. I want it to be linear. And I want infinite. So basically, that's going to rotate once every 2 seconds. It's going to be a linear rotation from the start. So it's going to start immediately at that speed. And it's going to rotate indefinitely. So this is pretty much the same speed as the spin. But now we only have a parameter we can change. So if I want to double the speed, so at least 2 seconds, it takes 2 seconds to do a 360. If I change that to 1, you can see that's now taking 1 second to do a complete rotation, and also I can slow it down. So I can take 3 seconds to do a 360 from there. Wait, I can really slow it down if you want that one. But we can also go something like 0.5 and make it take half a second to do a 360. So we'll put that back down to the default of 2 seconds. But there's also a couple of other things we can do. So instead of the icon, we can rotate the name if you want, or if you wanted to rotate the whole card, which, unless you've got circular buttons, not really going to make that much sense. So we'll put that back to icon. Now we've got everything in a list. We can also do this. If I copy that, go to here, start a new line, and then change that to name. I can have the icon and the name rotating within the card. So we'll just speed up the name. Finally, for rotation, we've obviously got a linear here. We can change that to an ease, and it will spin up and spin down. We can also go alternate, and it will go backwards and forwards. That doesn't really make sense unless it's doing that. So that's rotating, but what about flashing? That's simply a case of changing rotating to blink. And again, we've got similar controls. I can slow it down. I can speed it up. Or I can go like really stupid. So we won't leave that on there too long. And of course, we've got the same options as we had for card, which will flash the whole card. So if I slow the card down and speed the icon up, you can see that the card is flashing and everything's in it. So I'll put that back. We can change that obviously to name and just have the name flashing when it's on. And if I turn it off, that stops blinking. And of course, we can take that, start a new line, change that to name, and now we've got the name flashing independently. So now we've got the styles, icon, animation, and a blink on there. Because animation is now a list, we can now add in a rotation as well. So we can have it blinking and rotating when we turn it on. We'll just speed that up a little bit. And of course, we can do that. And once again, we can copy that. We could have the name doing something on its own. So we'll make the name flash pretty fast. I can also add a rotation to the name. It does that, backwards and forwards. Let's take that off the icon and we'll leave it on there. Flashes a bit fast now, let's change that down. And of course, if you really wanted to, we could do the whole thing. So let's make that a little bit slower and slow that right down. So as you can see, there's quite a lot of options with the custom button card. Next, I'm going to show you that not only can we change the color, make it spin or blink, but we can also change the icon itself. So at the moment, I've got the default icon, and obviously it stays with the default icon, but just currently turning it to red. However, if we add a line, say like icon with an MDI entry, and in this case, I'm using saw blade. When I turn it on, it changes the icon. And of course, if I put back the styles in, that rotates. Pretty cool. Finally, one thing you can do with the custom button card, we can change the icon on an on and off state. You can also make your own pictures. So for instance, I've got this one, nothing special. It's just a fan icon and I've just made it a little blurry so it looks like speed. When I make an icon, I make it small so it loads nice and quick. Mine are 48 by 48. In order for the custom button cards to load these images, they need to be in your www folder. If you haven't got one, make one. In the folder, you can put icons. I've got a few in here. I've got a fan off icon. These have got a transparent background as well. These are PNGs. If you want to use a JPEG, obviously you won't have a transparent background, but you can load them. Now, the easiest way to get files into your www folder is to use Visual Studio Code and then just drop it in and it will upload to that folder for you. Alternatively, if you haven't got Visual Studio installed, you can use the other Home Assistant add-on, which is Samba Share in Windows, and you can just drag and drop that and copy it into here. So how do we get that into our button? Two things we need to do. First of all, in the actual card itself, we need to put this line in, show entity picture true. Next, we want to have that blurred fan show up only when it's on. So we're going to add that in here. And for this, we need entity picture forward slash local, which is what Home Assistant sees your www folder as, and then obviously the name of the file, and in my case this is 3D fan on blur. So when I turn this on, it'll ignore the color because it's using the actual image instead. Now obviously if I want to make this red, I would have to make that image red, and as you can see, I've got a little blur icon when I turn it on. And of course, we've got to have it spinning. So yeah, that works. Well, I hope this video was helpful with your projects. Please do share it so others can find it as well. I upload videos whenever I can, so subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified. That's it. Thanks for watching.